Hey, church family. If you want to know what love is, I can't think of any better place to look than the way that the Bible defines it in 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 to 6. It defines love with these words. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. I wonder, how loving are you when you measure your love by those words? The particular phrase that I'd like to zero in on today is the one there at the end of verse 5, where it says, love keeps no record of being wronged. Or as other versions translate it, love does not take into account a wrong suffered. Did you see the story in the news recently about Daylan McClee? The report that I read said, there was a boom, and then the house shook. Daylan McClee thought for a minute it might have been a small earthquake, until a relative came running inside to say there'd been a car crash involving a police cruiser outside the apartment in Uniontown, Pennsylvania, about 45 miles south of Pittsburgh. McClee ran outside and pulled an officer from the mangled patrol car as flames began to spread into the cabin. Police officials and others have credited McClee with saving the officer's life after that Sunday evening crash. McClee said, I don't know what came across me, but I ripped the door open and just pulled him to safety across the street. Protests over police brutality following the death of George Floyd in Minneapolis have gripped our nation for weeks and have laid bare tensions between police and the communities they serve, exposing grave mistrust by civilians and frustration by law enforcement officers who say they're being painted with too broad a brush. But for McClee, the issue broke through the larger question on race and policing. It was about saving a life. What made Daylan McClee's bravery especially unusual is that he himself has been the victim of injustice in the past. McClee, who is black, spent a year in jail after an incident in March of 2016. Before a jury acquitted him of all charges after reviewing a security video. That year spent in jail was a year away from his children. It was a year away from his mother, who was ill at the time and has since passed away. The 31-year-old said it wasn't a complicated decision to help another human being. But even some of his close friends wondered whether he might have hesitated because of his previous interactions with a few law enforcement officers. No, he said. There's value in every human life. We're all children of God, and I can't imagine just watching anyone burn. He said, no matter what other people have done to me or other officers, I thought, this guy deserves to make it home safely to his family. After saving Officer Hanley's life, McClee said, we need to work on our humanity. That's the main problem of this world. We're stuck on how to get up or to get even. And that is not how I was raised to be. You learn, you live, you move on, and I was always taught to forgive big, he said. You can't base every day of your life off of one interaction you have with one individual. You know, as I read Daylan McClee's story, I thought, you'd be hard-pressed to find a better example of 1 Corinthians 13:5 and love not taking into account a wrong suffered. May his example challenge you and me to show that same kind of love in our relationships with others.